Let's now take a look at some cool projects that can inspire you on how to use the components discussed before. Here are some links to global and local websites. You can find many nice ideas in Hackaday, Magazine, and Instructables. You can join the Trondheim Make Fair to meet with local enthusiasts, or you can become a member of Hackaim to get access to their 3D printers, solderers, CNC machines, and any other tools that can help you with your projects. You can also follow some nice YouTube channels like Greg Scott, The 8-Bit Guy, and Derek Barnes, where you can learn about modern and vintage electronics. First project I want to show you is the suspended plotter that I made for the Trondheim Maker Faire. The basic idea is to have a pen hanging from two non-stretchable threads whose lengths can be controlled using two stepper motors. Each motor has a 3D printed pulley where the thread winds up, and the steppers are controlled by a microcontroller that reads a vector graphics file stored in a USB stick and uses Bezier curves and the Pythagorean theorem to calculate the target length of the threads. When the pen is not supposed to leave a mark in the board, a servo motor pushes it away from the surface. This is a video of the plotter drawing an ananas. You can see the servo pushing away the pen from the paper when it doesn't need to leave a mark. Porting the 3G reader to run in a microcontroller was quite challenging, but since I still had some RAM to spare, I also added a web server running in the microcontroller that exposes an interface to add files to the USB stick and start the plotting. Another project coming from a colleague in the Trondheim ARM office is this virtual pinball emulator. While the video game itself runs in a powerful x86 machine, it connected a few microcontrollers using USB. One microcontroller is in charge of driving the LCD matrix display, another drives some solenoids that emulate the banks of a real pinball, and another reads the buttons and the plunger. The next project is the arcade machine that you can play with in the Trondheim ARM office if you decide to join us. The microcontroller inside reads the status of all the buttons and exposes a USB human interface device for a couple of joysticks. The Mali Power development boards that lie on the top of the cabinet runs Android and drives the display and audio of the system. A very simple project that can be done with microcontrollers and some piezos is a MIDI controller that reads the vibrations of the piezos and translates them as USB MIDI signals to drive a drum synthesizer. USB MIDI is a well-defined protocol and you can use it to create inputs for any instrument you can think of. We already seen that piezos can read sounds or vibration and that they can produce sound. But another interesting application is to vibrate them at a specific frequency that vaporizes water. You can use it to make a humidifier or a desalinator, for example. Here you can see the Arduino Bob robot, which is a standard beginner project with open source 3D printable parts. It uses the ultrasonic sensors to avoid obstacles and servos for the leg movements. The final project I want to show you is something that I implemented in the Trondheim ARM office to automate the reset of some boards for our automatic testing infrastructure. What you can see in this feature is a set of 11 boards whose grounds are all connected and a microcontroller that resets them. A cable was soldered on the reset pin of each board and connected to the microcontroller in an open drain configuration, since the board uses 12 volts while the microcontroller is 12 volts tolerant but runs at 5 volts. The microcontroller runs ARM Embed's operating system and runs a remote procedure call server connected to the internal network. Thanks to this setup, we can easily reset a board remotely using a wget from the command line. I hope that seeing some projects got you inspired and trying and making some of your own, and you can follow the links in the video description for more information.